19 days after the sunken MTKR Terra Nova sank off Bataan, oil extraction may finally begin today, Tuesday. Pipes have already been installed that will siphon over 1 million liters of leaking industrial fuel.
Pagpunta kami yung mag-metal capping, ayun lang ang ginagawa namin. Try na kami magbutas ng LSS polo direct sa may cargo tank. Na itetest kami mamaya, pang nakabutas na kami, itetest namin yung flow rate ng ilan liter per hour.
Meanwhile, another sunken tanker, Jason Bradley, now partially afloat after days of operation to remove the water inside it. Once it reaches the surface, it will be towed to the shore to remove more than 5,000 liters of diesel on board. The Philippine Transportation Chief downplaying threats of more protests against government's public transport modernization program. Manila on Monday staged a surprise transport strike in parts of Metro Manila with another three-day protest with Piston set to begin Wednesday. But the DOTR only responded with another warning to operators and drivers with unconsolidated vehicles.
Magsisimula na rin kaming mag-trackdown ng mga nag-expire, yung mga franchise. At karamihan dito mga lumang sasakyan talaga eh.
Transport groups meanwhile appeal to President Marcos to heed their calls even if they are part of the minority. Marcos last week asserted he will follow what the majority wants, which is to continue the controversial modernization program.
Mahal na Pangulo! Pagpakalalaki ka, tignan mo yung mga taong bayan na hirap makasakay ngayon. Ito po, protesta pa lamang ito. Para sa amin, hindi pa po ito transport strike. Mas malala pa po ang mangyayari sa mga susunod na araw.
Dapat ang Pangulo ay dapat nakatingin sa dalawang side, hindi lamang sa isa, kung sino yung malapit sa kanya.
Manila set to protest the actions of Chinese fighter planes which endangered a Philippine Air Force patrol over the West Philippine Sea. The Philippine Defense Chief says China's aggressive actions in the area are only expected to continue. Michael Delizo reports.
The Chinese Air Force conducted dangerous maneuvers several times, not only against Philippine aircraft, but also against those of other countries in the South China Sea, according to the Philippine military. But on August 8th, the Philippines saw for the first time People's Liberation Army Air Force's dropping of flares, a move that could have endangered the plane and its crew. Flares are usually used to deflect an incoming missile as the plane's protection, but China used it differently.
For instance, yung mga flare na yon ay nakarating dun sa ating aircraft, no? Pwedeng mahigop dun sa propeller or sa intake, or pwedeng masunog pati yung ating aircraft. It's very dangerous, no?
Two multi-role fighters of the PLA Air Force were flying near the NC-212Y aircraft of PAF conducting maritime security operations in the airspace over Bajo de Masinloc. The incident came just over a month after the Philippines and China convened a bilateral consultation mechanism and agreed to lower the tensions in the South China Sea.
I don't know why they did it. You know, masabi ko, it certainly took us by surprise. China has always said it's wanted to de-escalate, but every time, of course, na may nangyayari na ganito, certainly it tends to raise tensions. So it's something that certainly we have to pay close attention to. Every time something like this happens, siyempre, you begin to think.
The National Maritime Council will meet this week to discuss the incident and come up with a response. But what is certain now is that the country will file a diplomatic protest.
Hindi tayo pwedeng pabayaan ito kahit na sabihin ng publiko diplomatic protest or whatnot. We cannot not do it kung hindi nag-aakyes tayo.
In a statement, the National Task Force for the West Philippine Sea called the air incident harassment against the Philippine aircraft, risking the safety of its crew. A political analyst and international relations expert says China is now leveling up its harassment not only in Philippine waters but also within Philippine airspace, and it puts China's sincerity to the escalate tensions in question.
Tingin ko exhaust lahat ng Chinese military at ng Chinese Coast Guard, lahat ng pwedeng posible paraan upang maharas tayo. Sincere ba talaga yung mga yung Chinese government sa kanilang pagpasok sa kasunduan para mawala ng relevance and significance ito ng PCM.
Chodora says China's action will likely continue.
We have to expect na ito ay continuous pattern na gagawin ng China laban sa atin. Ito ay continuous na struggle for presence and for assertion of sovereign rights in the area. So you will have to expect these things to happen.
Meanwhile, Senator Riz Ontiveros called on the Executive Department to start working on the filing of another case against China to hold it liable for its belligerence. She says China's encroachment of Philippine skies is unacceptable. House Speaker Martin Romualdez also condemned China's aggressive action, saying it is a threat to peace and stability in the region and does not speak well of a country trying to be a world power and leader. Following the new harassment, the armed forces said it will intensify the monitoring and patrol in the Philippine airspace. Michael Delizo, ABS-CBN News.
Several lawmakers calling out Vice President Sara Duterte for not speaking up against China's aggression in the West Philippine Sea. Members of the so-called Young Guns Bloc say, with the sovereignty of the Philippines being threatened, the Vice President cannot afford to stay silent on the matter.
Nakakabingi yung katahimikan. Eh, lahat naman tayo dito, mahal natin ang Pilipinas, diba? So dapat Pilipino ang kampihan nila.
Kung pag-uusapan natin ay soberanya na ng ating bansa, hindi po dapat natin ine-expect na dapat maglabas man lang siya ng kanyang pahayag, suporta, laban po sa China. At dapat magiging pro-Pinas dapat ang magiging pahayag niya. Pero for the longest time na naging vice presidente po siya noong July 1, 2022 hanggang ngayon, may narinig na po ba kayo na pahayag galing po sa ating vice presidente laban po sa China? Ang sagot po, wala. So ano po mang ibig sabihin nito?
For Lanao del Sur Representative Zia Lonto Adyong, the Vice President's silence speaks volumes about her leadership.
Whether or not her silence may be treated as an apathy or not really interested, that would definitely spell out and define the kind of leader that she is. Because we are looking at our leaders, especially those who have been given too much responsibility in duty, yung mga highest official ng ating bansa, na makita ang kanilang pagiging patriotismo.
The House Young Guns Bloc also denying alleged moves to impeach Vice President Sara Duterte. Former Duterte administration spokesman Harry Roque warned of the alleged plan in a social media post. Ako Biko Party List Representative Jill Bungalon insists there's no such talk in the House of Representatives, but he admits it would not be surprising for such a complaint to be filed.
Wala naman po kaming naririnig, but it would not be a surprise if somebody would file an impeachment case against the Vice President. So, hindi naman po katakataka. At hindi na po tayo mabibigla kung may mga ibang grupo or ibang individual.
Lanao del Sur Congressman Zia Lonto Adyong meanwhile says the Vice President should propose alternative solutions if she continues to criticize the policies of President Marcos. The Vice President previously blamed the President for recent severe floods and for allowing foreign interference in the country's affairs. Now let's get an update on the weather now from Pag-asa forecaster Veronica Torres. Good morning, Veronica.
Good morning, Ms. Bettina, and to all of our audience in DNC. Currently, southwest monsoon is still affecting Luzon and the western section of Visayas. And because of southwest monsoon, we're expecting cloudy skies with scattered winds and thunderstorms over Ilocos region, Zambales, Batanes, and Babuyan Islands. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms. We don't have any gale warning rays over any parts of the country, and currently we're monitoring a tropical cyclone outside the Philippine area of responsibility. This tropical cyclone has a low chance of entering the Philippine area of responsibility, and it's moving away from our landmass. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Veronica.